Valley News Live 10 at 10 continues with No Wait Weather.
Earlier in the afternoon, we had a round of thunder showers pass very close to the FM area as it exited south central parts of North Dakota, dumping tennis ball size hail and even some golf ball size hail reports as well. And now another round is on its way, this one with a very good chance of making its way into the FM area. Some scarier looking clouds off to the west that are lit by frequent lightning in the background. And these storms still each individually showing some signs of rotation. That risk for possible tornadoes is still there, folks, as we go into the dark hours of the night. And that's not something we typically see here as the lightning lights the background of the sky here. Let's take a look at the very latest. First and foremost, there have been a few counties trimmed from the watch box for our area. As we take a look at that, our westernmost counties, Stutzman, Foster, Eddy, Benson, all the way up towards the Towner County area, Dickey and Lemoore included, have been shaved off. The watch, tornado watch, remains in effect until midnight for most of our Red River Valley counties. Very heavy rain on the backside of this storm system in what we call a wake low, some gusty winds associated with that low pressure system. Over 60 miles per hour taking place up in the Northern Valley. Heavy rain continues there. The brunt of the stout thunderstorm activity extends from here in Marshall County, Minnesota, through the FM area and down south into Richland County. And there are active tornado warnings down in portions of eastern South Dakota right now. Let's get you into the FM area. We're just looking into the mouth of this thunderstorm complex as it works its way into the FM area. This extends from Norman County, once again near Ada, and again, now North Fargo, West Fargo, seeing the activity as is Kindred and the southern Red River Valley. Now, as we look into this, we do have several areas on the inflow side of the storm where we're seeing some slight signs of rotation. This is moving off to the east at about 25 miles per hour. So it's going to be moving through Fargo-Moorhead as I go through this very weathercast at this time, pressing into places like Holly here shortly within an hour or so. A lot of heavy rain. There's not much in the way of hail potential with this. There could be some small soft hail, but along the leading edge of this storm, we continue to see from time to time increased rotation in the storm. That's where we have the greens and the reds next to each other showing tight circulation. And there are a few areas of highlighted circulation in and around our area. We're going to be monitoring this very carefully as it works its way through, but right now, no warnings. Richland County, right along the southern Red River Valley, Breckenridge, Wahpeton, all the way out towards Pelican Rapids, these storms will be accelerating at about 25 miles per hour towards western Otter Tail County now, leaving behind in their wake some pretty heavy rain and some small softish hail. And again, in this area, seeing some weak signs of rotation from time to time. Now, as we look up in northwest Minnesota, again, heavy rain, a line of non-severe thunderstorm activity from Langdon southward through the Nelson County area continues. A wind warning, a high wind warning has been posted for our viewers in Kitson and Roseau County for non-thunderstorm related gusts of wind that could be upwards of 70 miles per hour. Storms in Beltrami County entering the Red Lakes area are strong, but at this time not severe. Look at all the lightning with these, and you're probably hearing them outside your window right now. The first storm moved through this way, left behind buckets of rain with training storms behind them. We had nearly 8 inches of rain estimated by radar in southern and western parts of Barnes County. And not far from Fargo, 3.7 estimated by radar, and a report from Argusville, thank you very much, of around 3.4 inches of rain. There is a flood advisory for Dickey and Lemoore County, Barnes County, as well as northern Cass and parts of Norman County. Current condition 65, Fargo thunderstorm in the vicinity, northwest winds at 16 miles per hour, almost everybody in the 60s until we get into our Lakes Country counties. There, things are a little bit warmer. Here is a look at the path of the storms between now and 11, crossing out of North Dakota into Minnesota exclusively by 1 a.m. Still a risk of some strong thunderstorms, but the main risk will be the gusty straight line winds. And as we go into tomorrow, look at this. Clear skies return. The rain is out of here. Light winds from the west or southwest up to 15 miles per hour. And a pretty quiet day across the valley as things go. So your planner for Fargo, you'll start out at the bus stop at 53, 71 or so tomorrow afternoon as a high temperature. That'll be about it. Most locations in the mid-60s to around 70 degrees to cap off your day. A great photo here of another sunset. This one, Dalton. Thanks, Diane, for sharing your photo. Now a look at your 7-day planner as we take a gander the next couple of days beyond today. Very quiet, and actually we return to warm Enjoy it, because there is another round of wet weather coming for Friday, for Saturday, and the Bison pregame show and the tailgating that'll be going on out there. I'm sure an umbrella will come in handy. That wet weather and cooler than average weather continues into early next week.
Okay, so we'll enjoy the next couple dry days.
Indeed.
Yeah, yes. Thanks, Hutch.